Hi, I'm JimKD and this is part 2 of my series on Bitcoin for normal people. In part 1 I talked about the basics of Bitcoin. If you already know the basics, you can skip it. But if you don't and haven't seen the video yet, please click the button to watch part 1 first. In part 2 I talk about using Bitcoin and in part 3 I'll show you how to recover from a failure of your computer. Unfortunately, the hardest part comes first. Don't worry, it's by far not as hard as making a bank account, does by no means take as much time, and I'm going to explain everything you need to know. Let's get started. The first thing you need to do is to install a wallet software. I recommend using Electrum. Just go to electrum.org and click on download. Choose the version for the operating system you're using in the easy installation table. I'm using a Linux operating system, so I'm going to use the first entry. But it's just installing a program. I'm sure you have done this many times. For Linux, you need to install Python first, if it isn't already installed. Just copy the first line, remember not to copy directly into the terminal, and execute it. I already used Python in the past, so nothing's to install, but paste this line or type it in anyway, just to be sure you have Python on your computer. Now I can move on to the second line. This will actually download and install Electrum. For Windows and OS X, you have to download a program through your browser and then install Electrum like you usually do. You can find the Android version in the Google Play Store. After you're done installing, you can launch Electrum. It's going to ask you what to do and you choose Create a new wallet and Standard wallet as the kind of wallet you want to create. Both is already selected by default. Click on Next and it will show you your wallet seed. Now there are two very important aspects of that seed. First of all, do not show your seed to anyone. Everyone who knows your seed has access to your wallet. Especially do not make a YouTube video in which the seed is visible. I transfer my money out of this wallet before I upload the video. Second of all, write your seed down onto a piece of paper and not on your computer. Because if your hard disk fails, you don't want your money to be gone with it. So take a minute to write it down onto a piece of paper. Double check all the words. After your computer failed or you accidentally deleted your wallet, you can restore your wallet using the seed, but we'll come to this in part 3. Now click on Next and you will be asked to type your seed in. Please really type it in from the piece of paper you wrote it on, so you can be sure everything is correct. So for me that's session sunny length feed achieve, I have to look desk devote cube extra plate brief list asset, and I will check this automatically whether it's correct. Capitalization doesn't matter, but the words have to be in the correct order, so make sure you don't just mix them up. Then click on Next. Now you can set a password. You won't need this password to recover your wallet. The seed is really everything you need, so you don't have to worry about forgetting your password. The password will stop someone who has access to your computer, but doesn't know the password or the seed from spending your money. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Please use something stronger. Then click on Next. Just click on Next here. After that's done, you have successfully created a wallet. That's somewhat like a bank account. It enables you to send and receive money. Now let's go to actually using the wallet. You can see in the bottom left that there currently is no money in the wallet. 0 millibitcoins. To get some money in Bitcoin, you can ask someone who has Bitcoin or use a Bitcoin exchange. In any case, you need to provide them an address to send the money to, because addresses is what money can be sent to. Click on the tab Addresses to see the ones you already have. You can pick any of them and give it to someone else so they can send money to you. I'll pick the first one. Just right click it and choose copy to clipboard. You can now paste this address in an email, a chat, or on a website of an exchange, or wherever. You can also note for yourself what this payment you want to receive is about. For this, right click an address and choose request payment. Then enter a description. John gives me my first bitcoins. And enter the amount. 50 millibitcoin is about 25 euros or $30. US dollars, of course. John is a really nice guy and will transfer the money soon, so one day is okay. Click on save. Now this is just a kind of built-in note program. It doesn't send a notification to anyone. You don't need to save a note like this to receive a payment. You just need to give someone the address to pay to, and of course the amount. Notes are purely for you, and you get this label on the address so you know that it's already in use. You can reuse addresses an arbitrary number of times, but it's recommended to only use the address once for privacy reasons. You get more addresses as you use these up, and you'll get as many as you need. Addresses are completely free. Oh, and by the way, these addresses are unlike your bank information. People can only send money to them. They can't take money away from them like they can if they know your bank information and steal your money via direct debit. So you don't need to worry about this if you negotiate a deal with someone you don't know online and you are paid Bitcoin. Now let's say John gives you 50 milli Bitcoin. I'll just do this on my phone, and you give him $30 or 25 euros in exchange. Or you transfer money from the Bitcoin exchange to your wallet. Regardless of whether you told Electrum that you were expecting a payment, you'll see the transaction in the history as soon as it happens. This is in real time. That is, of course, if you're online and connected to an Electrum server. You can see I'm online and connected to one because the symbol in the bottom right is green. So right now the transaction is unconfirmed, and you can see your unconfirmed balance in the bottom left corner of the window. This means you have no certainty that the money is yours yet. Depending on how big of a fee John paid, the transaction will have a smaller or bigger chance of being confirmed within the next few minutes. Once it is confirmed, you can see this because one segment of the circle is filled, John can't turn around and spend his money elsewhere. However, it's still not certain that you actually have the money. You don't need to know the technical details of this, but you should know that that's the way it is. The number of confirmations will now grow, regardless of the fee John paid. You can see this in the form of the segments of the circle. Statistically, the transaction gets one confirmation every 10 minutes, but it can be more or less. After about 3 to 6 confirmations, you can be very sure that the money is yours, depending on who you ask. This is why Electrum shows you the transaction as confirmed when 6 confirmations are reached. It then shows you a checkmark on the transaction instead of the segmented circle. Once that's the case, you can also see that the payment status in the Receive tab changed from pending to paid. But you can already spend your money if there only is a single confirmation. You should be more careful if you think John has malicious intents. But even if he has and tries to take the money away after first showing you that he made the transaction, it's very unlikely that he'll succeed once there are 2 or 3 confirmations. Really, he already has to be lucky to be able to take the money away from you after there was 1 confirmation. Let's move on to sending money. There's a small change in settings I recommend you to make. And if you don't understand what I say in the next minute or so, don't worry. I'll tell you what to do in this case in the end. The symbol here is for preferences. You can click on it to determine how much you spend per transaction. You have to pay a fee per transaction, and if you set a higher fee, your transaction is more likely to be processed very soon. If you don't want to pay much, set it to a small amount. Setting it to 0.1 millibitcoin per kilobyte instead of the default 0.5 millibitcoin per kilobyte should be perfectly fine, and your transactions should still go through fairly fast. The transactions get better and better chances of going through very soon if you pay a higher fee up to about 0.2 millibitcoin per kilobyte. As a rough estimate, a typical transaction is about 0.25 kilobyte in size. Choose for yourself. If this confuses you too much, just set it to 0.1 millibitcoin or 0.2 millibitcoin per kilobyte, and you'll pay about 1 or 2 cents per transaction. You don't need to change anything else in the settings, so click close. If you buy something, the shop will give you an address and the amount you have to pay. Let's say you order something small for 20 millibitcoin. Just click on the Send tab and enter this information. You don't need an IBAN or a BIC, the name of the bank you sent the money to, the name of the person you are sending the money to, the account number, or the info to put the reference field so the shop knows which purchase this payment belongs to. Just the address and the amount. You can enter a description, but it will not be sent. This again is just a note for you. You don't need information for a reference field because the shop will give out a new address for every purchase. Remember, addresses are completely free and you can have an arbitrary amount of them. If you're done, hit send. Since spending your money is something only you should be able to do, you need to enter your password. 123456. After you did this, your transaction is sent. You can see your transaction in your wallet history. It currently is unconfirmed. That's why you now have a lower unconfirmed balance. Depending on your fee, the transaction will stay unconfirmed for some time. If you chose a really small fee, for example 0.01 millibitcoin per kilobyte, so there's an extra zero in there instead of the 0.1 millibitcoin per kilobyte I just entered, this can even be hours. But regardless of the fee, the transaction will not just sit there for days and days, sometimes even for weeks if you pay someone in a different country and use bank remittances. So Bitcoin is quite a bit faster than this. Plus, it doesn't care about weekends. To sum it up, if you entered a reasonable fee, it'll probably be confirmed within a few minutes. If you entered the smallest fee possible, it'll likely be a matter of hours. Anyways, your transaction is sent. You don't need to keep your computer or Electrum running. The transaction has been sent. You can create more wallets in Electrum and send money between these wallets. You can also send money to your own addresses within a single wallet. No one besides you even knows that these addresses belong to the same wallet. We are now done with the essentials of sending and receiving money. In the third part of this series, I'll show you how to recover your wallet and what the consequences of this are. You can click subscribe to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on the third part of future videos, or you can click on the arrow to get to the third part if it's already out. Thanks for watching and have a lovely day. You don't need an IBAN or a BIC, the name of the bank you're sending the money to, the name of the person you sent the money to, the account number, the info to put in the reference field so the shop knows which person... Fuck!